Here we go. Hey, it's the Lenny's Virtual Show. It's the Lenny's Virtual. When I say Lenny's Virtual Show, y'all gotta say "Oh Show." Y'all gotta do the background vocals, babies. I need y'all to learn this. It's the Lenny's Virtual Show. That's y'all. Oh Show. Let me stress you. I'm Boogie B and I'm the roving. Let me stress you out post quarantine. Everybody's locked up, phones all in paper, but I'ma come through with New Orleans flavor. Comedy soldier, joke Rambo, putting green in my team like I play a Lambo. My team gets stacked and we're going ham, bro, but I'ma stop rapping and tell a damn joke. Let's go. Hey, it's the Let Me Stress You. Hey, what's happening, Tennille? It's the meet and greet portion of the show. I'm about to open it up and talk to y'all. I'm looking good in my bed and my Pepsi Blue on them Pepsi Blue when I come on through. It's the Pepsi Blue when I come on through. Hey, y'all know what time of day it is. Lamonta Woods tripping. I ain't never tripping. You came in here first in the comments. What's up, Daphne from New Orleans? What's up, baby? What's up, Shawana Shanks, my little lesbian partner? She's so pretty and chocolate. She'll make you think she want to hunch on you. She look a little cute enough for you to try to poke her. She'll play you with that good personality, and next thing you know, you're a man trying to hunch on a lesbian. Lord, this is a Hunch Day Wednesday, ladies and gentlemen. You done caught yourself looking at Shawana Shanks titties. And you were like, you know what, Shawana, cool as a mother. I might go ahead and try to hunch on old LaWanda Wood. I mean, old Shawana. Sorry, LaWanda. Oh, y'all having so much fun already. It's Hunch Day. Y'all know what time of day it is when I come through. You know what I'm going to do when I'm come through on a Hunch Day, Shawana Shanks. Somebody will try to... What's up, Monique, Nick, and Wilkerson? Monique, Nick, and Wilkerson. What's happening, baby? From the Baltimore area, my stomping ground. What's happening? Danielle with the D from the UK. What's welcome from the UK. Thank you for sharing the live. They put it right over your head. Thank you so much, my UK partner, Danielle with the D. Thank you so much for posting this Cash App at the bottom, Vice President. I'm so glad I have you on the show every day to keep the show flowing smoothly. As y'all can see, it's the Cash App is pinned at the bottom. It is Boogie B LLC. You see it at the bottom of the screen, and it also says, let me stress you out, show life. I am your host, comedian Boogie B, the New Orleans representative, a.k.a. the mouth of the South, a.k.a. Mr. Camille. Let me stress you out. Can't nobody do it like me. Oh, can't nobody do it like me. Oh, can't nobody do it like me. Oh, can't nobody do it like me. Hey, I'm glad y'all here. My Boogie B, I've always here. Make sure y'all share the live. Let me get my phone so I can show y'all how to share it, too. I need y'all to follow along with me in your books. Follow along before I call on you to read. I might call on one of y'all to read at any moment. Now, you never know. So be paying attention. What's happening, Don Barry? I know y'all be busy, but chill for a second for this little hour. Chill for this little hour. Relax. Whatever you're doing, ain't going nowhere. Whatever you doing, ain't going nowhere. It'll be there when you come back for it. Lake Shay Renee, that's how your grandmother used to tell you. It'll be there when you come back for it. Don't worry about it, LaWanda Woods Griffin. That damn homework ain't going nowhere. That damn job ain't going nowhere. This show is moving forward. It's forward moving, baby. It's upward lifting. Hey, I got y'all in here, and I'm so thankful for y'all to come in here, too. Because y'all know how I get behind y'all. This is the Let Me Stress You Out show, so y'all know I wrote somebody on y'all behalf. Whoever got something on their mind, on their heart, on their chest, come on, dude. Let me know what the problem is. What the problem is. Y'all remember that? What's up, Andrea? You with the U. What's up, Andre Red Thomas, my high school boogie bro and boogie Joe and Joe and Andre will be stopping through every day for the longest since the beginning of the pandemic. What's happening, Sonya Beasley? Sonya Beasley, you in California? Let me look at your picture right fast. Let me see what you got going on in there. Sonya Beasley, who is all them people in your head? Shot profile picture. Baby, let me tell you what you do on social media. You take your picture. I don't care who you're in love with. I don't care how big your family is. On your main picture, put you right there. Put you so then I can see you and be attracted to you. And I can give a damn about what's going on in your family after that. But when you put all these 50 million people in your damn small ass little headshot picture, hey, what else I'm supposed to judge a book by? I can't see the inside of the book by walking by it. I can only see the cover. So I'm judging the book by the cover, most likely. And I'ma just look at it and be like, who is all them people? I don't know. I wanna see your family reunion. I don't even know which one of y'all this is. Who profile is this? Is this you? Is this grandma? Is you the little boy? Is you the girl? I don't know who you is. You're gonna put all these people. Dashelle. I try to help him, Dashelle. I'm glad you came, baby, because you know what, Dashelle? I needed to tell you something. I've been waiting on you to come so I can give you this trophy. I've been waiting on you to come to the Let Me Stretch You Out show so that I can let you know that your name, Dashelle, is a very, what you call, how do we call it on this show, ladies and gentlemen? We call it a what? A two black parent name of the day. That's the two black parent name of the day is Dashelle. Dashelle, white people always know you. It ain't nothing you can put under your resume to make them think you not black. I don't care how many credits you got. I don't care how much of college and everything. That you could have went to Harvard. If your name is Dashelle or Dashelle, let me tell you something. They gonna automatically know that you're black. They just gonna know that your accreditation is good as well. But let me tell you this, we gotta give you a trophy of upliftment for all the judgment that you had to push through your whole life. The prejudgment. They didn't even know if you was a good person or not. They just automatically assume, because my name, Dashelle, is Dashelle, Dashelle, or Dashelle. I don't care which one you call it. I don't care how you put the accent on it. It is still the blackest name possible that you could have and push through the capitalist society with. Dashelle, your name got chosen from Mount Negrosis. And it was probably somewhere around, your name was chosen somewhere around the Juneteenth holiday. It was a black, somebody went up to the Mount Secaucus, to the Mount Negrosis, and chose that name, Dashelle. The shell, Michelle, LaShelle, it's all kind of damn shells in here. I see shells on the seashore in this bitch. I see shells. What's all these shells is attracted to Boogie Beefa? I don't understand why. I tell you, and Brandon Beverly, when I be turning them names out, you think I be bullshit when I be telling you I met this person, this name person before, or that. I know the shells. I know all of them. The shells, the LaShelles, the Michelles. I even know Detroit shells. I know a whole lot of shells. I done dated a whole lot of shells. Shells are always attracted to me, and I find the commonality between them all. Sonya Beasley, I'm not only giving her the trophy for the two black parent name of the day, Dashelle. I'm giving you that she got the niggified name, Andre with the U. Hell yeah, I like when you put a little Negro on it. Put a little Negro on it if you can. That's how I order my food. Hey, if you don't mind, fix me a mashed potatoes and fix me a macaroni and cheese and put me a baked chicken on there and put me a little broccoli, and I would like you to sprinkle some Negro on it if you could. Sprinkle me a heaping helping a Negro on mine. That's how I like mine. Johnny Brown said the Shellishas. Damn, I done had them all. Don't worry about it. Any type of shell variation, Boogie B done had it, I know about it. And I'm going to tell you what, they some hunching helpers. Since it's a hunch day Wednesday, let me tell you who's some hunches. By name, by general rule, if you ever meet a shell, if she call herself shell, If her name's Lushell, Mushell, Tushell, Crushell, any of the shells, this goes for all of y'all. Y'all shells and some old hunches, you hunch your back. You hunch your back when you're doing it, because you're a huncher. Even when the ding-a-ling knee, you're still hunching. Y'all know what hunching is? When you put your body on somebody's body and you just... you just freaking off. You just... you be like, damn, would you hurry up and put this ding-a-ling in? Why we doing all this without... We could be having sex by now. We hunching like a dog right now. Why are we hunching like this? Because my name is LaShell, or Michelle, or Tushell, or Dushell, or Dashell, Dayshell. It is what it is. What it is. You're going to have to unjoin me for about 30 to 45 minutes before I will allow you to put through this coochie. Hey, them shells going to make you wait all. You're going to hunch for a long time. You be like, I know she know I want this coochie. What is the problem? She knows she about to give it to me. I don't know why she making me go through all this. She's just a hunch and won't take nothing off. Soon as you try to pull them drawers. And keep going. You like, a lot of it. Well, what is we going to keep going doing this for? What is the point of doing this? If you going to eventually crack down and give me this coochie, or we just going to roll around with our clothes on? All day, all night. You just got me with my chin. You're about to get a splinter in my ding-a-ling because I'm grinding my wood so hard. I'm about to scratch a hole in my zipper. I'm about to scratch a hole in my penis with all this hunching with these shells. I promise you. Hey, let me tell you something, Sonya Beasley, baby. Hey, Sonya, I don't stress people out unless they deserve it. That's not stressing out. That's upliftment and letting y'all know what y'all dealing with. Look at LaShell Miles put in. Yepers, I got a bunch of LaShells in here. Look at these. They agree. They agree. Before they want to get you, before they like you, they going to make you hunch on them. That's why it's a hunch day Wednesday. That's why I call it hunch day instead of hump day. Because ain't nobody humping around. Who is this, Bobby Brown? No, this ain't that. Before that, we was hunching. Before we was humping around. And before we felt like it was getting over the hump in the middle of the week, I want you to get over the hump. Get over the hunch in the middle of the week. Get your hunch on those nasty-ass shells in here, all y'all. And that shell, goddamn. Thank you for accepting your trophy so gracefully for the Two Black Parent name of the day. Hey, I just go on and on, on and on, on and on. Mad props, such a want the same. I'm feeling Robbie GC, cause my high is coming down. Michelle is yours, but you do not know her worth. She know that word out the Bible. Sonya, what's happening, baby? It's a midday hunch, baby. It's a hunch day. Come on in here and do your hips like, just do your hips like, man, put your tongue out like that. Like you about to get nasty when you get home with your old man. I'm about to hunch on you, boy. You gotta lick that tongue out one time when you say that. I'm about to hunch on you. And you gotta snap when you say it. I'm about to hunch on you. Cause you about to put a rhythm on that. You better tell them, let's say Renee, it's a commercial break. Drop it like a, let me see who all new in here. Monique Nicky Wilkerson, you didn't order your Verb Energy bars yet, sweetheart. I need you to order these from the link in my bio, okay? This is plant-based energy bars. One bar is a power of the same as the power of a cup of coffee. And it's all natural, so it's good for you. And that coffee ain't good for you, Sonya. Some of them be drinking too much coffee. I don't know who it is in here, but Sonya or LaShell, somebody knows somebody that drank too many cups of coffee a day. And they need to replace it with the Verb. They need to replace three of them cups of coffee for a Verb energy bar. Tell them, tag them in it, and let them, and send them the link. When you go to the link in my bio, send it to whoever drinking all that coffee. Stinking, they about to pull up the whole damn bathroom. booty smelling like a Juan Valdez donkey. It smell like a whole donkey coffee booty bitch. You go in that bathroom like, ugh, why it smell like a Folgers crystal shitty factory in here? It's a shit grows, it's a Folgers shit stoves. It smells horrible in here. It smells like the best part of waking up is poo-poo in your cup. Somebody be going in that bathroom at the job every day. I be coming in there, who booty smelling like coffee like this? Why is a bathroom? Did you bring the coffee in the bathroom with you and didn't take a poo? What is you can't let that coffee go for a while? Why you didn't leave that coffee in the break room or put that coffee in the refrigerator till you came back? Or put it in the microwave till you got finished pooing? You had to bring that whole cup of coffee. That's what I think they so hooked on it. That's why I want you to get your Verb energy bars. Because people is getting too hooked on that coffee. The ones who getting on it, ugh, it's terrible for your body. You can't keep pooing like that. It's smelling up the whole. You got my whole household smelling like a fresh brew factory in there. Stop brewing all that damn coffee. As soon as I wake up, I'm smelling, ugh, what is that? Smell like my sheets is made out of coffee all of a sudden because you're brewing that coffee every damn morning. Get your damn Verb energy bar and replace one of them cups of coffee. I ain't gonna keep playing with these now. I'm gonna have to tell them, hey, you order the Verb because this your third cup. And I'm about to start, it smell like a brewed damn bed factory in here in the damn household. Stop all that coffee and get your Verb energy bar. That's enough. One cup is enough per day. And I don't even really want that. I wish you'd cut back on that. And make it once a week because you smell like a shitty Folger crystal booty ass. I can't do that. Hell no, Shawana Shanks. Y'all got to start getting y'all health together. Hey, just before the show even starts, start getting y'all damn health together. Drink you some more water. Drink you some more spring water, okay? It has to be spring, not purified, not distilled, not that old spring water, baby. All y'all need to start drinking double amount of it. Especially if you're drinking some coffee. You need to be drinking so much water to flush all that damn coffee out your system. You need to drink that, and you need to get on some sea moss. You need to get on some sea moss, some oregano oil. You need to get on this. So plenty of things that you need to take, supplements. They're not supplements. They like take vitamins. Stop taking your vitamin, the multivitamin shit, with all that weird shit in it, and start taking some regular holistic multivitamins, because I want you to be healthy enough to come to the Let Me Stress You Out show every day and have a good attitude. Hey, Maria Davis, baby, I appreciate you. Your order is on its way, I promise you. Thank you, Joel Buku, for coming. I appreciate you. Danielle with a D, you know I love all of y'all. Double dicks and boogie bro. Woo! Shawana Shanks, what's happening? Just going. Hey, I be bashing coffee. I do be bashing coffee because that shit ain't good for you. I'm a coffee basher. I never drank a cup of coffee in my life. I drink a damn hot cocoa, but I ain't gonna drink no coffee. Nikki Hannah, what's up, baby? You're late, but you're right on time for the time. What's up, Tippy Nippy? Living in multiples, we used to actually go and pump our water. That was dope down memory lane. Okay, Tippy Nippy, y'all used to go pump your water, baby. Yeah, that's back in the old school days. You get your well water. You must be an old country girl. Shawana Shanks, that's how you promote. You got a coffee badge to promote. Coffee do have its benefits. I ain't going to say nothing. It's terrible for you. But just once in a while, don't overdo it, is what I'm trying to tell you. If you're overdoing it with the coffee, then you need to order you some Verb energy bars so that you can offset some of that coffee you drink. Marie Jume, what's up, baby? Thank you for sharing the live, too. I appreciate that. Hey, Tippy Nippy, let me 10,000 likes. Okay, God damn. All right, Adnanoid, live, what's happening? Yeah, they like that coffee. Y'all, I know y'all like y'all little coffee in here. I know some of y'all like y'all little coffee, but just don't be drinking too much is all I'm saying. The extreme is what I'm talking about. Oh, Tiffany, I know you didn't see that coffee's bad. You can't drink too much. I know y'all love it, but one cup a day. Limit yourself and try to cut it down to 2 cups a week or 3 cups a week. Just so you ain't drinking so much with stain your teeth and all that. You know, I want y'all to be very, you know, love is a verb. Verb energy balls. It's real talk. Thank you so much, at the Lord, my research department. Joanna Shanks. You ready for this? I got another good one for you, Joanna Shanks. I got one good for you, Wayne. Hold up. Stress out Trick Daddy, bro. I already stressed out Trick Daddy Dollars. He's entitled to his opinion, but his opinion is a bad opinion. If you think Beyonce can't sing, you need to research singers. You need to go talk to some singers and see what the singers say about Beyonce's voice. It's not a bad voice, I promise you, it's not. Let me tell you what can't sing sound like versus Beyonce. Let me tell you. Me, I can't sing. Now let me show you what can't sing sound like, and you tell me if I sound better than Beyonce. Loving you is easy cause you're beautiful. Shimmy-dee-dee-dee. Sha-la-la-la-la. Hallelujah. How's that, huh? That's when you can't sing. Can't sing. So when some of y'all be taking it to the extreme, Beyonce can't sing. No, 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 no. Boogie B can't sing. Beyonce can sing in multiple different times, genres of music. Her voice is transcending the barriers of rap and pop and rock and R&B. She's done it all. That lady is a talented individual, and to say she cannot sing is a problem with your opinion. You're being way too judgmental there, Trick Daddy. You talking about she ain't no Stephanie Mills. Stephanie Mills ain't no damn... I don't want to hear no damn Stephanie Mills. I'll turn that shit off every time I hear that. Click out on. But Beyonce will hold my attention. I'll be like, oh, I let me get you, baby. She'll have you singing it with her. Even though you a dude, you be up in the house talking about, let me get out to you. Cause lady, hey, I like that mama. I want to be your prime, your little to live. That's the least I can do. Let me cater to you. Cause you're in love. I'll be in that bitch singing that motherfucker like a woman. Hey, Randy Watson. That nigga can't sing either. Hey, that bitch, though, I don't care what y'all talking about. It's a bunch of great singers in our day. But Beyonce is, to me, is kind of uncomparable to anybody else. Because her skills is so wide ranging. For y'all to say that she cannot sing, you can say you don't like her, but you can't say she cannot sing. No, not to you. That means you don't have a musical ear. That means there's something wrong. You need a miracle ear because you don't have a musical ear. How about that? Because you don't know nothing about music if you say that girl cannot sing. Hello, Hope Harmony. I'm sorry, baby. You're late, but you're right on time in this rhyme. Don't hate on Stephanie. I like Stephanie Mills, too, but I ain't no, that wouldn't be no substitute for Beyonce. If I got to get rid of one, if I could only keep Beyonce or Stephanie Mills, I'm keeping Beyonce all day. So, anyway, Mike Matchin, let me bring y'all into the inbox of the day. Somebody inboxed me a conundrum, as they always do, a doozy, a tizzy, whatever you like to call it. Okay, Amy Ross with the songs. I can't think of damn Stephanie Mills song, I'll tell you that. Patti LaBelle is good, too. I love Patti LaBelle. She is the queen of whatever she was doing. But Beyonce is the queen of what she's doing as well. It cannot discredit the queens of everything. Whitney Houston was the queen of the night. And Beyonce is the queen of right now. She's the queen, so I mean, you can hate all you want. But that goddamn boogie beehive is gonna let you know, hey, we fuck with now Beyonce now. She can sing. Aaron Carter's Beyonce Experience, we love you, queen. You goddamn right, we love you, Beyonce, baby. Keep doing what you're doing. Old country Houston girl, you with them thick old eyebrows. You was not supposed, ain't nobody thought you was gonna be shit. When you was a kid, they probably was looking at you like, oh, she ain't gonna be the one. She ain't gonna be the next Aretha Franklin, I bet you that. And I bet you was wrong. and they counted her out, I always go for the underdog. Jay-Z and Beyonce was underdogs. And I always root for the underdog, especially after they win it, because I'm the underdog. Ladies and gentlemen, you're looking at the most underrated, one of the most underrated stand-up comedians of my time. Underrated. Okay, well, whatever. Say what you want. Argue what you want. I'm just going to tell you. Argue with your funky ass mom. I tell you that. Don't argue with me, shit. I feel like I'm the damn most underrated, or one of the most underrated comedians in our current new times of comedy. Anyway, Tiffany, I celebrate all of my boogies and boogie bros for coming through. And I ask y'all and I take y'all advice into understanding. So somebody inbox me and ask me. Oh, yeah. Ooh, wait, what is Shawana and Atna Loy in here talking about? I want to give you my breath and my strength. And Shawana Shank came in there talking about you would. Wait, what y'all got going on in here? What's going on over here, Shawana Shank? What you is? Wait, whoa. Because I know Atna Loy will swing east side of the fence now. If I know Atna Loy Yolanda correctly, she swings on both sides of the gate, if you will. And I know Shawana Shanks is strictly coochily. She's strictly pokily poke poke. And I see them having a little altercation right there. It seems like somebody might have made a little connection of y'all might have rubbed them vaginas together before. I ain't in your business. I'm just saying it sounds like what y'all doing in here is arguing. It sounds domestic a little bit. I don't know what y'all saying right there. Oh, you talking about the song, big bro? Well, hey, I don't know now. What's going on? That look a little suspect. Oh, Yolanda Atna Loy said I bagged that already. Meaning that she did rub coochies with my own girl, Shawana Shanks. Who knew? But what the hell y'all little nasty asses been doing in here? I didn't know y'all had bumped uglies. Now, you ain't tell me you had bumped uglies. Y'all ain't said nothing. Yeah, you know I had them bump uglies with your research department. Shawana Shanks, what's going on in here? You didn't tell me you had them. You done smashed my research department. You didn't tell me that. Wayne, they in here freaking. You see them, Wayne? Look at them. Look at them in the comments. They in here are freaking on the weekday. They hunt. It's a hunch day Wednesday on here. Them and Nikki Hannah, they done rubbed them damn twats together. You know. Did you know that? They done did their thing. Who they been coming here for? Damn near since the beginning of the pandemic. I think Shawana might have been here first. And damn came, and then all of a sudden my research department saw coming every day. I'm thinking they both just into me. Them motherfuckers in here arguing with each other. You know what? I done knocked you off before. They shooting subliminal shots at each other. I didn't even know in the comments. Antoinette Robinson, who else, did anybody else pick up on this besides me, or is it just me? Let me see, some of my bookettes have been coming in every day. They know the situation in these comments. Nothing current years and years ago. Stop trying to kill her new. Oh, she got a new thing. Okay, I see what y'all doing in here. Tiffany, you see what's going on? Exodus, hold up. Let me put you up on game, Exodus. I'm king. Exodus, it's two girls in here. That's one, now Shawana Shank, that's my lesbian partner. She on the pokey poke poke side. Carmen Rodriguez, hold on. She the one who, you know, she used the scrap on. She the one more likely to scrap the dingling on. Yeah, out of the two women, if you had two women together, she more than likely one to rough fuck you. You know what I mean? She the most likely to choke you out while she's giving you the fake dingling. Anyways, and she's been coming here for years, and I know our old lady been watching the show as well. I never damn knew that she done, my research department is also used to have it. I never knew. Shit, they just came in here freaking. I don't even know what's going on. Now I see why y'all was hunching, because it's in y'all eyes. Y'all got the same type of comedy humor style, because you done rubbed them vaginas together. You done rub the same type of comedy on each other. That's why all y'all here. This is a three-way. It's me, Adna Lloyd, Shawana Shanks. It's Shawana Shanks, old lady. Y'all the three-way. I'm just on the screen. And we all on the screen. But I ain't in it. I ain't hunching on none of y'all. I'm just watching y'all do y'all thing. I'm just trying to get y'all all on one accord, if you will. Thank you so much, Shawana Shanks. I love you, baby. I'm so glad you be coming. Hey, you have an extra room for me? Hey, you can't stay here now. You can't stay with me and try to eat up all the coochie I get. Hell no. Hell no. I can't do that with my lesbian partners. Hell no. They too persuasive to live with me. You been ate up all that damn coochie. Hell no. I can't take no chances, Shawana Shanks. Not that you'll do that to me. But your charm is electric, you must admit. And you might fuck around and I bring my little thing over to the house. You come over there looking good with the dreadlocks, chocolates, cool as hell, we'll smoke a little joint with her. Next thing you know, she don't even want my ding-a-ling no more. I can't take no chances. You like, no, Boogie, you can have her. I'm like, but you know, she don't want me. She done fell in love with your swag. Hell no. Mm-mm. Can't take no chances. I can't compete with that. Hell no. I'd like to keep my lesbian circle closed, but not that close. No, no, no. You can't stay with me and eat up all my coochie. Hell no. Or you gonna bring over here somebody too damn bad. That's another problem I be having with y'all, Shawana Shanks. You come over to the house, you bring your company, come over looking better than my company. And I'll be like, hold up. Now see, you bullshitting in here. Because you... How your company all tens and my shit go up and down. I done sat my company next to your company. I'm like, yeah, damn. Well, shit, how you get up? Ah, damn. Yeah, I'm looking at your company like, yeah. I mean, you know what? Shawana, let's try to, do you like mine? Mine, she cool as hell. She, you know, I know you like bad ones, but would you prefer to let me, could you talk her into it? Just to help me out. I want you to talk up. You don't come over here with all them bad ass women. Don't you bring all them bad women to my damn crib, old lesbian girl. Hell no. I ain't living with you bringing all these bad bras up in here. And don't like me. They ain't even. Yeah, he all right. I mean, I'm like, damn. What the fuck? Shawana Shanks look better than me to y'all. Look at y'all. Get y'all asses out of here. You don't fuck my confidence up. I ain't doing it. No. No, hell no, Nikki Hanna. And you know they might eat the coochie and the booty. Them lesbian girls, hell no, you even took my girl. Nope. I might not want to eat my girl booty yet. Next thing you know, you talking about, you know, I eat everything down now. That nigga Boogie don't want to eat no booty, he said. He said in his little comedy, he don't want to eat no butt. She's chuckling it up. My girl like, why are you laughing so hard? Why are you laughing like that? Because what? Because Big and Shawana, yeah, because I eat everything down now. I cleans the plate. You be like, my girl be like, oh, wow. So that's what y'all doing over there? Mm. All right, well, pass me that little weed. Let me hit your little marijuana, Shawana. Y'all got me totally off the track. Y'all got me totally off the track messing with damn Shawana Shanks and damn Adna Lloyd and Sabrina. It's a hunch day. You know I always do that on hunch days. You know I get off on the track and start doing some whole other shit. Anyway, just can't call it a cookie bush. Just don't call it the cookie bush. I don't need no cookie bush. Okay, Adna Lloyd, thank you, baby. I love y'all, my lesbian gay partners. I need all y'all. At TransUnion, TransWestern, TransVestern, with TransVest, SSBS, all the CIS. Oh, I need all that shit. I need it all. I need all the acronyms and all the LGBTQIA community to come here to express your opinions on shit. Let me know how y'all do it in y'all relationship too. This 2022. I never know who I'm gonna have to educate. I never know who I'm gonna have to teach about something. And I wanna be done got it firsthand from my lesbian partners, Shawana, Adam, I mean, Bishop, whatever y'all call yourselves these days. They've spoken about before. Oh, okay, I ain't know they spoke about that before. I must have missed them comments, Danielle, with the D. You caught it. Hope Harmony, yeah, you know I'm going to keep it all the way real on here. Love is a beautiful thing with the right person. It don't matter who sex, what type of penis or vagina that they have. It only matters what type of mentality they have. I don't care whether you're slinging coochie, slinging dick, eating coochie, eating dick. I don't care what you eat. As long as you got a good head on your shoulders, you're welcome at the Let Me Stretch Your Show every day, any day, 5 days a week. Now, let me tell y'all what's going on in the inbox. Somebody told me to ask y'all that she says she in a relationship. Been in a relationship for about 3 years. He cheated on her. She took him back, but she ain't really been feeling it like that. And he said that she gets a pass to cheat if it'll help anything out. And she want to know, should she take the pass or not? Should she take the call pass? Because, so, and you think she should take that and it'll help her get over it? Or you feel like she shouldn't take it and just break up with her? What y'all feel like? Or what you, I don't know, because she could just stay with him and don't break it and just forget about the whole shit. A one-time pass. If your mate's apology says that you could just cheat back on them, what you gonna do? Maria Davis says, take the pass. Marie Zulme says, no, don't take it. Amy Ross with the Souls from New Orleans says, no, just leave. Tina Ronan said, do it anyway. Vice President said, two wrongs don't make a right. Two wrongs in the night, I kept you guessing. It's all I can do. Two wrongs don't make a right. And it was, let me tell y'all how the whole situation went down. Wayne said, give me the pass. Hold on, Wayne. Let me tell y'all the whole situation went down first, though. It was his co-worker that she kept saying, that girl like you. That girl like you. That girl, he like, man, that girl don't like me, man. We co-workers. She know better than that. She know you. She cool with you. She ain't like that. She kept blowing it off. She kept like, no. He wasn't fucking with it like that. Genuinely legit. He wasn't fucking with it like that. He was like, nah, nah, nah. But his girl, my baguette, kept saying she like it. She like it. Next thing you know, he done tapped that ass. Hey, on the desk, at the job, she pulled that ding-a-ling out. He couldn't help himself. He passed the burner, no return. And he did something he wasn't supposed to do. Okay, well, you know. Players fuck up. Joe the Hero, my partner Joe Thomas said, take the pass. It ain't gonna make it better. Just take a break and reevaluate the relationship. Joe said, reevaluate the relationship. Step back for a minute. Calm down, take a look. Wait, he slept with my friend. No, he slept with his coworker, whom you knew, whom you have come across a time or two. You know, she was at the little company picnic, you know. She said hi to you or whatever. He told you, he introduced y'all or whatever. But you know, you said it then. She like you. She like you. She said she like Pepsi Blue. You got on Pepsi Blue and she likes you. Camille said apologies do not equate to cheating passes, ladies and gentlemen. Camille McIntyre says, apologies, amen, do not equate to cheating passes, hallelujah. Come on now, what's going on? I don't understand what's happening here. Oh, Lord, I can't catch up with the comments. Y'all making me laugh too much while I'm reading this shit. What's good, Lavendopoles? I'm glad you made it, brother. You know, you should be on track by now. I think I summed it up quick enough for you. Hope Harmony said, okay, well, he giving me a pass. I can sleep with one of my coworkers. Oh, shit. Ooh, woman to woman. Petty, petty white, what's happening, baby? Hope Harmony says she gonna turn into Petty, petty white. Petty, petty white. She says, okay, well, if you giving me a pass, I'm going to take the pass, and I'm going to put this coochie on Big James. Big James at the job. He be coming through this motherfucker every day. He come through on Friday with sweatpants on. He been looking at my booty because I caught him a couple of times. I know that he wants to hit this, and James, old big tall handsome nigga too. He old pretty, oak tree color ass nigga too. A tall, dark and handsome. And guess what? Your old lady about to take that pass, Wayne. Wayne, you say you taking a pass? Your old lady should take that pass if you give it to her. She about to put that coochie on Big James from the job. And Big James gonna beat your girlfriend's cervix up 2 inches. She gonna beat your girlfriend's belly button over to the left or to the right. I promise you, if you let her take that pass, she gonna get beat out the frame. She might not even waste it on the nigga she don't know about. She might go and fuck somebody who she know had all that beef on. And then and he was probably a dumb boy or something. You know how he ain't too bright, but he got all that dick. She probably will call him up and say, what's up? What's up with you? Yeah. How you doing, Big James? Yeah, your old country ass got all that dick on you. You still got all that dick you had on you before? When we when Cash Money took over in the 99 and the 2000? He gonna be like, hell yeah, I still got it. He dumb as fuck. Hell yeah, I still got it. Yeah, I damn sure do still got that dick. What happened over there? What's wrong with your man broke up? Oh, that nigga said he gonna give me a pass, baby. He said he cheated on me, so he said I could get a pass, and I'm taking my pass, because I'm taking my pass. And I'm about to give this coochie to Big Dumb James. And Big Dumb James right about still dumb as hell with a whole bunch of stretch you out penis on him. And he about to hit your old lady with a whammy bammy. And she gonna come back to you loose and wide. She gonna come back to you wider than the Jordan River. Flow chilly and cold. That coochie gonna be bust over like the Jordan River, baby. Chilly and cold. Chili and cold. Y'all remember on baptismal day? Ooh, that coochie gonna be baptismal poo big when you get up in it. If you let her take that pass, fellas, I promise you. Hey, women cheat. Hey, listen, I'll tell you something. Fellas, this shit getting real critical right here. It's getting real critical. If you didn't cheat it and you got caught, And you don't let your lady cheat. Don't say that. Don't give her no pass. Because if she take that pass, you're going to regret it. It's going to hurt you more than it's going to help you. Hey, don't you do it. Don't you do it. Hey, listen, Tawana Shane said you right about still dumb James. You damn right, Big James dumb as hell. And he about to beat your damn spine loose. And you gonna come back home to me like ain't that happened. How you doing? Chewing a gum. Why? Let me put my purse down. How are you? Feeling good. Yes, you want something to eat? I'm gonna fix you something. You want a wine? I'm gonna pour myself a glass of wine. You're coming this bitch very nice. And very polite and very relaxed. You coming in this bitch just done got off Big James' dick. Hell no. I know exactly what just happened. Nope. Ain't no way I'm going through that shit. Nope. Sorry, Lake Chain Renee. I ain't giving up no pass. I ain't giving out shit. Hey, I don't care what I did. Don't break up with me shit. Break up with me. This is the WWBBD portion of the show. What Boogie B do? Break up. If I cheated on you and you think I'm going to give you a pass to go cheat on me, nope. I'm petty and it can't genius. Shit, I fucked up. Hey, but if you want to push through it, let's try to push through it. Let's do what the best we can, because I do love you. I fucked that girl on top of the... on top of the credenza at work. I had that booty bent up on the credenza. I apologize because she... But you told me she was on me. I didn't know we was working late. She pulled my ding-a-ling out and just started sucking it. I couldn't do nothing. You know, I'm powerless once I start getting my ding-a-ling sucked. She got me. I couldn't do nothing. She put it right out. Hey, I apologize. I don't love her. She done got fired. I ain't get her fired, but she got fired. Let's just say that. And let's just try to move on, you know, and try to push, because I ain't going to fall for that again. She got me with a banana in the tailpipe. Because she put the banana in the tailpipe, Jovan Johnson. Why you acting funny with all your money? Tell me why you acting bad with your kitty cat. Hey, you're mad because I got something. I'm sorry, baby. I apologize. But ain't gonna be no giving of the passes. Ain't gonna be no giving of the passes. I ain't giving no pass. Don't worry about none of the rest of it. Don't worry about it. If you do it, do it. Don't get caught. Because I do not want to know that I gave you a pass and to cheat on me because I cheated on you. And now I got to live with knowing that you have a pass every day. You gonna come in there purposely looking good. Purposely looking like you fucked somebody when you didn't. You gonna just play mind games with me the whole rest of the relationship. You never even cashed your pass in. But every week, I get an inkling that you cashed your pass in. I'll be like, hold up. Did you cash your pass in? Why you got all this Bath and Body Works on today? Where you was? You was at the gym. What? Yeah, you might have been at the gym of that dick. That where you was at. No, you coming in this bitch too cheerful till the bitch came from the gym. What's going on? Did you cash in that pass? No, boy, don't be stupid. I ain't cashing no goddamn... I'm a cash in a pass on your little stupid self just because your little stupid self cheated on somebody. I'm not playing that game with you. She knows good damn well you done gave it. She gonna use it. Apologize and hunch after, Camille said. Listen, y'all going ham in these comments today, baby. She tricked me. You said, tricked me. I don't love you. I don't love her. Oh, yeah, she tricked me. Yeah, she tricked me. That's how she got me. She put me in a good... Shawana Shanks, what you gonna do if she just bust out, you know, just can't start eating that cooch or something? Or she just come to work one day and she just put a vagina right in your mouth or something? You like, damn, now she know I can't resist this. What if you just walking at the job, Shawana Shanks and the little chick, she just grab your hand and just put it up under her skirt, no drawers on. That ain't your fault. What you supposed to do after that? You got to hit that ass on the credenza. On the credenza. The credenza. You got to hit that ass on the credenza then. Because, you know, hey, you was at the front of no return. So what happened? Hey, it happens. I understand. I can totally understand it. There's no excuse for it. There's no excuse for it, Nikki Hannah. If shit just happens. And when it do happen, you got a decision to make, ladies. You have a decision to make, gentlemen, whether to leave or to stay. Now, once you decide to stay, you trying to harp on it, harp over it, over and over and over. That's not going to make it no better. It's not going to make it no better. So you're going to make him put him in the corner to make him feel like he have to give you a cheating pass. And then you take the pass. Hey, Wayne Brown, don't fall for it. If your old lady gives you, say, nah, we ain't want no cheating pass. Don't let's not even discuss that. Let me just move on. Because if you force it on me, I will take it. And guess what? I'm going to slang this dick when you least expect it. Don't you then be done cheated on me. You cheated on me and you going to give me a pass? Or I'm definitely going to play mind games with you. I'm definitely coming home with a big old banana in my pocket. I'm going to come home with a hard, it look like I got a hard banana in my pocket. I'm going to come home with my ding-a-ling so hard. I'm going to come in out because I'm going to jack in the car. And then I'm going to come in the house and then let you see it. And I'm going to walk by you. Yeah, just got off from work, work late. Yeah, just work late, you know, with the staff, all the ladies of the company. Just finished getting off from work with them, you know what I mean? What is that in your pants? What do you mean? What you talking about? That's regular me. What you mean? No, sir, you are on a bone. You're on a heart. You have a heart on. Why are you coming from work? Did you use that pass that I gave you tonight? Nine? What you mean? Pass? What? I forgot all about that damn pass. You say gave me a pass. I ain't remember nothing about that. I'm going to play mind games with you. I ain't fuck nobody. I'm going to come in there with a big old penis package. Oh, don't give me no pass. Don't give Boogie B no pass. Just let it, whatever happens, happen. If I do slip up, then just take your lick. If I don't slip up and you done cheated, then well, you made it. If you cheated on me and we got back together, because some of y'all talking about I ain't going to break up with nobody for cheating. I'ma just break up with them soon as they cheat on me. Well, you ain't never been in love, I guess. You don't know the power of love. Luther sung about it. What he said? The power of love. Yeah, make you let a cheat on you one time. Just one time. It might make them cheat on you. Just one time, you done let them get away with it. Just one time, you took that nigga back. You know you weren't supposed to, but that's the power of love. Anger tingling. Hey, Wayne Brown says, if you think that's right. You never loved him. Is some niggas out there that you fall in love with that will make you do something strange for a little piece of change? I promise you. You just ain't met them yet. I don't know who they are in your life, but they are somebody around you. Or somebody in your past experience. Either way. Did y'all share that live? I need to share that live late. I'm sharing the live late as hell. I forgot the day I'm sharing live all this whole time, and I was telling y'all to do it. Wayne, thank you for coming, Wayne. Big Swift on there. You stayed here the whole time. My boogie bro in here chiming in, letting y'all know from the male perspective. Brandon Beverly, we got us one. We got us another boogie bro to come through now. Brandon Beverly, it ain't going to just be me and you and all these ladies no more. It's about to be me, you, Joe. Don't forget, it's a couple of my little boogie bro squad. We ain't deep, but we in here. We in here. We growing. It's a lot more bookettes than it is bros. I need my bros to come through every day too. I need our opinion to support this shit, because they going to think I'm making this shit up if y'all don't back me up. Hey, I'm here 5 days a week. Wayne, I need y'all niggas, man. I'm in here by myself, holding it down, letting them know the truth. They going to argue with me. They going to say, Boogie B, you dang, if I give you a pass, you better not do that. You better not play no mind games with me. That's how they in here acting right now, probably to themselves while I was saying that shit. Oh, hell no, I ain't going to be in no relationship with Boogie B and give him no pass, because his old dog ass going to use it. Now they just know. See, they don't want to accept. They don't want to accept. You shouldn't have gave it to me. You shouldn't have gave. I didn't tell you to give it to me. I told you I ain't want it. You said keep it anyway. I said, well, all right. Well, since you want to play like that, now you about to get the mind games on. Because you shouldn't have cheated on me first, then. I should, damn. I'm going to torture your ass for the whole. And then if you fuck up too bad, I might call in that motherfucker on your ass. I might call in my love. Magnolia Shade will come through. Magnolia Shade will come through for it, Brandon Beverly. It's a Chicken of Magnolia Project. Her name is Shade. They call her Mac. Her name's Tashi, but they call her Magnolia Shade. And she call herself One Shade. One Shade is on. Good Magnolia Shade. Let me tell you something. She a real nigga. And she'll come through for you if you need that coochie. On a humbug, if you just need to get some good coochie to get back in your relationship, she'll come through if you call her. And we all know the number. Don't make me use it. Do not force me into the corner. with this shit. You done cheated on me. Now you want to give a thing a pass so I can leave you alone about it, okay? Well, I'm going to leave you alone about it, but I'm going to stress you out knowing that you're going to have, that I got access to sling a ding-a-ling on you. Michelle Ann Parker, you just checking in? You got to come to IG. You got to come to IG because you done missed the whole damn show. You missed the Hit the Cash app. You missed the Verb Energy Bar commercial. You done missed the, you done missed everything. You done give the, you done missed all the show. You missed everything. Damn, Melissa Ann Parker coming in this late talking about something. Hey, y'all. Hey, y'all. I ain't hear no damn hey, y'all, this late. What's happening, Hope Harmony? Hope Harmony said I should, she shouldn't take the pass. It's the principle. So, whoa. Some of y'all saying she should break up with a man. I never tell people to break up with nobody in their relationship. I never do that. Why? Because I don't know the level of dick this man done put on her. I can tell her and she take my advice. Shawana Shanks, what if I tell the girl, so look, just, okay, he doing that? Okay, break up with him then. Don't just break up with him. Leave him, girl, because he ain't, you know, he ain't right. He cheated on you. Leave him. I can tell you that. And you leave him. Tanya, but some of these women will lead these niggas and spiral down into crack cocaine. I don't know y'all personally. So I don't know when you tell me your little problem, I ain't about to get you. Yes, I done seen some dicks. I done seen some dingling put a girl in a mental institution. I done seen her break up with a dude and get in a mental institution, a group home. I done seen all type of shit. A women's battered shelter. Dingling's make you do a whole. Especially when she loved the dude that's attached to it. Ooh! That'll make her do something strange for no piece of change, honestly. If you break up with him, this might be your last time on the Let Me Show You How to Show. So I don't want you to, I ain't never telling you to break up with the nigga. I'ma tell you that, listen, hey, don't take the pass. Tell him, y'all, let's just talk it out. Let's get to the root of it. Let's go to counseling. Let's just try to get past, let me just get past it. I took it back. You're a good nigga. Your Pepsi Blue look good on you. I want to give you this coochie again. I'm sorry. I fucked up. I popped this coochie for a pork chop. Whatever happened, be honest. Come clean. Confess your sin. Say, look, I did it. But let's go live. You know, we ain't nobody need for no pass. Ain't nobody need for no petty Eddie and no petty, Betty, we don't need to turn into that couple. We just need to come together and figure it out. I apologize. I ain't gonna do it no more. Cool. You feel what I'm saying? Let's move on. And you, at some point, you gotta move on in life. It's a forward-moving thing, life is. It never stays in one spot. You can't stay in one spot. Your relationship gonna have ups and downs. Just know that. This is the Let Me Stress You Out show. I am your host, comedian Boogie B. I'm going to see y'all tomorrow. It's a hunch day today. Come on and go with me. Come on over to IG. I said it's not far from here. I'm about to go to Instagram and start over. Come on, y'all. @comedianBoogieB.